We want a very warm welcome to the International Church of Shanghai Sunday service. My name is Josh, and we're excited to have you join us today. We continue to worship online as we await the restart of our in-person services. As soon as we hear any further news, we will let you know, so thank you for your ongoing patience and prayers. In just a moment, our praise and worship team will lead us in preparing our hearts to come before God. And Pastor Dan will bring us another exciting message from the Lord this week. But before that, I have some announcements that I'd like to give for your information. Just a friendly reminder that ICS is a multi-denominational Christian church. In compliance to the local government regulations, ICS online services and events are open to holders of foreign passports only. If you're watching this for the first time, you're living in Shanghai, new to our church, or already a member of the church but wanting to get more involved, we run around 20 cell groups throughout the city on a weekly basis. If you want to know where these groups are or want to be connected, please scan the QR code and leave your request. Our church staff will reach out to you to get you connected. Anchor Youth continues to meet via Zoom at 10 a.m. every Sunday until church services resume gathering. If you'd like to be involved but haven't already, feel free to email anchor@icshq.org to be part of Anchor Youth. Do you know of anyone who's a believer and may be interested to work at our church? ICS is looking to hire an executive administrative assistant. For more details on the role, please send an email to what is shown on the screen below. A big part of life of our church is Expatriate Center, or TEC, which is a community platform that organizes events throughout the year. ICS is one of the ambassador centers for TEC. We have always been a huge part of their events. TEC hereby invites you to take action to help alleviate the current situation in India through our India Project COVID-19 Relief Initiative. Learn more about how you can support this fundraising project by scanning the QR code below. Let's stand hand in hand to help India fight against COVID-19. The International 3E Fair. Do you have a brilliant idea waiting to be cranked out? Submit your business proposal and put your idea to test at our TEC Social Entrepreneur Competition. Each team will be guided by an experienced mentor, giving you insight that would give you a successful start towards your idea. Registration and business proposal submission deadline is June 13th. Scan the QR code and sign up now. Last but not least, we'd love to thank all of our members for your tithes and offerings. It makes a real difference, not only in our operations of our church, but also allowing us to be blessed, to bless the community around us. One thing to note, please do not use the WeChat Pay at this time. We are addressing some technical issues, and we will let you know for further information as we get this figured out. But on the other hand, you are able to give tithes and offerings through our Alipay account via the QR code shown on the screen below. You may leave the Alipay remarks in the remittance blank. Thank you so much for your support. And before our worship team comes and leads us into worship, I'd like to open us up in prayer. Dear my Father, I just pray for Pastor Daniel as he ministers to our congregation via online sermons, and the Lord's presence to be among our online service and worship session today. Pray for all of our online viewers to prepare our hearts and to come before the Lord and to worship our God wholeheartedly and to receive his word for us today. Amen. Again, I thank you for joining us today, and we hope that you have a blessed Sunday worshiping the Lord together as a body of Christ. We look forward to seeing you soon.
The days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. and all the days of greatness, of famine and darkness as well. See other voice in the pleasure, crying, prepare the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet calls, oh, lift your voice, ear of jubilee, out of Zion's hill salvation comes. These are the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as black. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, the fields are as white in the wall. We are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet calls, lift your voice, ear of jubilee, out of Zion's hill salvation come. Behold, he comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet calls, lift your voice, ear of jubilee, out of Zion's hill salvation come. There's no God like Jehovah. 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 Behold, he's come, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, ear of jubilee, out of Zion's hill salvation come. Behold, he comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, so lift your voice, ear of jubilee, out of Zion's hill salvation come. Behold, he comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, so lift your voice, it's here up to the lake, I hope Zion's hill salvation. Behold, behold, he comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, so lift your voice, it's here up to the lake, out of Zion's hill salvation come. And out of Zion's hill salvation
to heaven and spoke your name into the night. Then through the darkness, your loving kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished and is written, Jesus Christ, my living hope. could imagine. So great a mercy, one heart could fathom. So spotless grace, the God of ages stepped down from glory to wear my sin and bear my shame. The cross has broken, I am forgiven. The King of Kings calls me his own. Beautiful Savior, I'm yours forever. Jesus Christ, my living. Inscribe on me, you have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name, Jesus Christ, my living hope. Then came the morning. Years of promise, your buried body began to break out of the silence. The roaring lion declared the grave has no claim on me. Yes, Lord. Then came the morning. The promise, your buried body began to break out of the silence. The roaring lion declared the grave has no claim on me. Jesus, yours is the
face, oh God of Jacob, and oh God.
seek your face, O God of Jacob. We bow our heart, we bend our knees, O Spirit, come make us humble. We turn our eyes from evil things, oh Lord, we cast out our idols. Give us clean hands, give us pure heart. Let us not lift our souls to another. Give us clean hands, give us pure heart.
Thank you.
that saved the wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
rest my soul. In Christ our Lord, know His power. In quietness and trust, when the oceans
Father, we give you praise and thanks for a brand new Sunday. We'd like to come before you to offer up prayers for the people in Osaka, where the hospitals are overwhelmed by COVID-19 patients. We pray for the medical personnel, that Father, you watch over them and protect them. I pray that Father, you will refresh their strength. And I pray that Father, you protect each and every one of us, regardless whether we are in Shanghai or in different parts of the world. We pray for all the different authorities across the world that, Father, they will be able to quickly vaccinate everyone. And I pray that, Father, we will be cooperative in coming forth to be vaccinated, because we know that nobody is safe until everyone is safe. So we believe that, Father, you are good and faithful God. We just commit ourselves to you. We believe that there's power in your word. We also give you praise and thanks that, Father, you have given us this opportunity to continue to worship you with our tithes and our offering. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Have you ever been hurt by someone's word? Most definitely. In fact, we might have been the one who has caused hurt to the others with our words and actions. All of us are work in progress in this aspect of our lives. The intent of this sermon is not for us to use it to throw stones at others, but to make a reflection on our own lives so that all of us will be able to contribute to a peaceful, gracious environment, regardless whether it's in a family, the office, or in the neighborhood. I have good news for you that we are able to get better by the day if we allow the Holy Spirit to work within us. Turn with me to Luke chapter 6. Verse 43 to verse 45 from the New King James Version, it says, "For a good tree does not bear bad fruit, nor does a bad tree bear good fruit. For every tree is known by its own fruit. For men do not gather figs from thorns, nor do they gather grapes from a bramble bush. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart brings forth good, and an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart brings forth evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks." I would like to take this opportunity to say a big thank you to those people who have submitted anonymously regarding some hurtful comments that they have experienced in real life in an effort to help me preach this sermon. Jesus used an agricultural metaphor to teach about character and conduct. Jesus taught us how the Christian lifestyle and manner of speech should be like in order to set us apart from the world. Good or bad tree? Verse 33 and to 44 of the main text says, "For a good tree does not bear bad fruit, nor does a bad tree bear good fruit. For every tree is known by its own fruit. For men do not gather figs from thorns, nor do they gather grapes from a bramble bush. Every tree is known by its fruit, which simply means we should expect apple from an apple tree. Basically, we cannot fake it because the tree will naturally have the fruit that it should bear. Likewise, we should be producing the kind of fruit that we should be bearing, and people expect us to bear fruit based on who we profess to be. Allow me to show you the different kinds of trees based on what the Bible reveals to us. The bad tree. Verse 45b of the main text says, "An evil man of the evil treasure of his heart brings forth evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks." The utterance from our mouths comes from our hearts. Jesus was referring to an evil man who lives and speaks out of the evil treasure of his heart. One of the ways where evil is manifested is in the life of a person through toxic relationship. There are toxic relationships either among friends, family members, or between a married couple. You will find that a person is very controlling in a toxic relationship. There is no support for you and it's all about the other person. There's no kindness and empathy in the speech. Instead, it is filled with sarcasm, criticism, and overt hostility. Besides verbal abuse, it will lead to physical abuse if it is not managed well. He manipulates and controls the relationship through words, including emotional blackmails. The relationship is filled with resentment, jealousy that makes one feel as though she is walking on eggshells around this person. There is total disregard of the other person and will often make decisions without consulting nor respecting the other person. One might be dragged into a huge financial commitment without being consulted. One will find that she is constantly under stress because you will not know what will trigger the person into a rage. The person is so self-centered who will completely ignore the need of others. The heart of this person is evil. He is a liar and manipulator. Just like the devil is a deceiver, tormentor, and oppressor. He will make the person feel oppressed, trapped, threatened, and fearful to leave the relationship despite of the toxicity in the relationship. The person being harmed in this relationship might even be deceived into thinking that everything is done for the good of the relationship. It is harmful and hurtful. Push a pause button for such kind of relationship. Seek help if you are the tormentor or being tormented. The evil treasure has to do with the sin nature. John 8:44 of the New King James Version says, "You are of your father, the devil. The desires of your father you want to do. He was a murderer from the beginning and does not stand in the truth, because there's no truth in him. When he speaks a lie, he speaks from his own resources, for he is a liar and the father of it." The devil is the father of lies and there's no truth in him. The sin nature reigns in the lives of the unbelievers, therefore they will be dictated by it. The devil is speaking from his own resources when he lies to us. Jesus is referring to the heart when he talks about speaking from his own resources. You will realize that it's often oppressive when someone has ill intention towards the other. There's nothing good in the heart of the devil. It is filled with darkness, immorality, and evil. He is a deceiver. His objectives are to kill, steal, and destroy. Likewise, it is natural and normal when an unbeliever operates through the sin nature. The sin nature is self-centered, therefore everything that the person does will be for self-gratification and pleasures. These people will devise schemes, connive, and use unethical ways to achieve what they desire. There's no truth in what they say or promise, neither will they deliver what they have agreed with you. That's the fruit that's produced from the bad tree. Let me give you an example. I was helping a family whose loved one was locked up in detention center because he committed some offense. Obviously, the loved ones were concerned and were at a loss regarding what they can do or cannot do. They were concerned about the state of his being because they were living in a foreign land. It was a desperate situation. The consulate wasn't able to provide much help because they are not able to interfere in local jurisdiction. And that's understandable. Some friends of the family recommended an attorney to look into the possibility of working out on getting the person bailed out while waiting for trial. There was something amiss when the attorney came and spoke to the family. Immediately, he asked the family for an equivalent of renminbi 200,000 in order to bail the person out, but couldn't promise when the person will be released. I called a police friend of mine to ascertain what are the procedures for such offences. There wasn't any law nor anything written in black and white that such procedures are allowed to pay an equivalent of 200,000 RMB and to get the person out. I was told that the person has to be put in detention for at least 4 days before being released and wait for the trial. The attorney was lying to cheat the distressed family for the money. The attorney knew what the accused will be when the accused will be released, which will be after a few days in detention. He withheld the information from the family just to make the equivalent of RMB 200,000. It was a shocking experience for me and the family because you seldom expect an attorney to be so despicable in cheating the family when they are in distress. The attorney lied to the family, and that's the fruit that is produced from a bad tree. A man blinded by money and brought disgrace to his profession. Let me give you another example. There was a manager whom the owner of the company has entrusted all the entire operation to him. This manager was trained and groomed to be a good businessman by the owner. The business was doing very well as the nature of the business was very unique and served a very niche market. He has acquired everything that he needed to know about the business and the supply chain. This manager quietly started another company offering similar business without the knowledge of the current business owner. He was channeling business to his own company instead of representing his present company, although he was still under the payroll of this company. He betrayed the trust of the business owner. This manager produced bad fruit, and it belongs to a bad tree. Verse 45b of the main text says, "And an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart brings forth evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks." Out of the evil treasures of the heart will speak forth vindictive, evil, destructive, and devouring words. It is never pleasant to listen to words that does not edify. It is especially unpleasant when it is spoken in front of a group of people with the intention to belittle, to harm, to make the person look extremely bad. There will be emotional scar in the heart of the listener. If the person who is at the receiving end of these unpleasant remarks were to retaliate in the same evil and vicious manner, then we will devour one another through words. The relationship will never be good because it has been strained and torn apart by words. Allow me to share with you some examples of destructive words. Whenever two sisters argue, the non-adopted one will say to the adopted one, "You are not even one of us. You were adopted." The adopted one will reply to the non-adopted one, "They chose me, but with you, they had no choice." Can you imagine when they reply each other in this manner? The relationship will never be pleasant. The relationship will never be restored. Let me give you another example. In a gathering, this person said, "When you express your own feelings or echo someone else, your spouse will say to you, 'What do you know?' It makes you feel that you are not worthy, important, or respected." You know, in a Christian setting between husband and wife, it is important for us to protect our spouse. It is important for us not to make our spouse look bad in front of everyone, because they are bones of our bones, flesh of our flesh. We are one flesh. We are to cherish and to nourish our spouse and to protect them. The next example, this person says, "On a generic level, when I was growing up, the words never and always were used frequently to describe or exaggerate behaviors. I found this hurtful as they were not normally fully true and made me feel shame and guilt. I was told repeatedly that I had such great talent, but was so laid back, I was virtually horizontal. And this only encouraged my passivity. In reality, I did not want to face the possibility that if I worked hard and failed, then maybe I did not even have talent. The thing is, when we go into a tit-for-tat relationship using our words to harm each other, then we will never get out of the vicious cycle. Someone has to start to speak blessing and words that edify so that you will break the cycle and bring restoration to the relationship. I'm sure that one will never feel good to be the person who is receiving the remarks or the person who said it. There have been a lot of emotional scars and even post-traumatic stress disorder for those who have gone through a toxic relationship. There are children who have been so put down by words that it affects their self-confidence and self-esteem for life. This is especially true when these words come from people whom they respect, like their parents or teachers. The other kind of verbal abuse will be from peers bullying through social media. There are those who felt that they will never be good enough because the parents have unrealistic demands on them. Unfortunately, those who have a sharp tongue or are unkind with their words will also be probably a victim of verbal abuse and has developed a way to protect themselves by being confrontational and abusive themselves. It is sad. It is sad that sometimes when someone thinks that they are entitled to belittle another person just because he's smarter, wealthier, or holds a higher office. Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth will speak. And it will reveal what kind of person we are. All that we have been bottling in our hearts will be blurted out. And this is especially true when we are under stress. It is seldom a pleasant sight. All of us are already living in a broken world together. Therefore, we as believers should make a difference by speaking kindly and graciously with words that encourage one another. As a Christian, the Holy Spirit will be grieved within us when we speak word that doesn't bring love, edification, and peace in a relationship. We can be different, especially when we are born again. We're able to turn the situation around for ourselves with the people around us and the family. God has enabled us to do it. A good tree. Verse 43 of the main text says, for a good tree does not bear bad fruit, nor does a bad tree bear good fruit. Now, since a good tree will produce good fruit, therefore everyone will expect a Christian to be a person of integrity and also operates the company with good moral values. It is an expectation from church members and also people in the world. They might not have articulated it, but it's a given thing that Christians are different. Allow me to use an example. Someone said to a Christian, you should be ashamed of yourself. That is not a Christian thing to do. Well, it is a hurtful word, but a truthful word from someone who has been observing our lives and expectation that Christians should be different in our speech, behavior, lifestyle, and work ethics. The comment came as an observation regarding the kind of fruit that we are producing in our lives. While we can be hurt or even felt condemned by the comment, we are supposed to be the salt and light of the world. I would think that it is good for someone to be able to speak into our lives so that it will hold us accountable and be on guard. While the positional truth that's found in the epistles to the church in Ephesus teaches us that we are holy, blameless, and righteous before God in Christ. These are spiritual blessings that God has chosen to bless us. Positional truth means how God has chosen to look at us in Christ, although we are imperfect in our ways. However, we are to intentionally walk in this positional truth as we live out the consecrated lives for the Lord. We will make adjustments to our speech and lifestyle through the enablement and empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Let us remember that we are not perfect and will never be perfect until we get to heaven. All of us are work in progress. We should learn to accept this before any one of us goes away feeling condemned with comments like the above. Honestly, it is a conscientious effort through the reminder of the Holy Spirit and having a renewed mind to help us walk out the truth in our lives. We will grow from spiritual infancy after receiving Christ as our Lord and Savior. We will continue to grow spiritually as we use the Word of God to renew our mind. We will grow into maturity when we are able to rightly divide the Word and live out the Holy Spirit-empowered life. We will always have to deal with the flesh, even when we have grown or continue to grow in the Lord. The natural instinct is for us to respond in the flesh rather than yield to the Holy Spirit, especially when we are hurt or offended. We have to remind ourselves that we are connected to God, who will enable us to produce the right kind of fruit in our lives. In fact, the fruit of the Holy Spirit is already present in us when we are born again. Therefore, we need to allow the fruit of the Holy Spirit to be evident in our lives. The fruit of the Holy Spirit is shown when we exercise the ability to bridle our tongue with the fruit of self-control, patience, kindness, and goodness towards the person whenever we are tempted to lash out at them. John 15, verse 4 and 5 of the New King James Version says, "Abide in me, and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself. Unless it abides in the vine, neither can you, unless you abide in me. I am the vine, and you are the branches. He who abides in me, and I in him, bears much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing." We need to know that we are attached to Jesus, the grapevine, and we are the branches in order for us to be able to produce the correct kind of fruits in our lives. We used to operate in the sin nature when we were sinners, so our flesh is used to it. The fleshly reactions are fed by our senses. We react based on the sense of sight, sound, smell, touch, and taste. We behave ourselves and speak out of the resources of our hearts. We will do better in the aspect of our words and actions when we continue to grow in the Lord. Praise the Lord, we will bear good fruit when we abide in Him as He abides in us. Let us refresh our mind that we are new creation, 2 Corinthians 5:17, in Christ. We are given a new heart, or our spirit being is completely new. We have the nature of God in the new creation, 2 Peter 1:3 to 4. The old nature has been done away with, and therefore we have the nature of God, which is the new resources in our lives. The new resources are found in our hearts where the new creation is located. We're able to produce good fruit because we are connected to the correct vine. Jesus is the vine and we are the branches. We're able to produce much fruit in our lives regardless whether it is in works, lifestyle, and the way we speak when we choose to abide in Christ. These are very powerful truths that the Lord has chosen to reveal to us through scriptures. We are born again after we have chosen to acknowledge Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. This happened after we have confessed with our mouth and believe in our hearts that Jesus Christ is our Lord and Savior. The new creation is in the heart or the hidden man, as the Bible says. God has given us everything that pertains to life and godliness because we have the nature of God. Therefore, this new life in Christ will enable us to live a godly life in holiness, including getting a grip of our lip and tongue. There is fresh water flowing out of you. It brings forth life and blessing to the people around you. Amen? We need to remind ourselves that we are no longer the old person who used to speak negatively, condescendingly, pessimistically, or even divisively. Once we have confessed with our mouth and believe in our hearts, we are a new creation. We have the nature of God and the Holy Spirit living in us. We have the fruit of the Holy Spirit that consists of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and self-control in us. We are able to have self-control over our tongue. There is a spiritual growth process after someone receives Christ. We will grow from carnality to spiritual maturity. When someone is a carnal Christian, means he's saved but still possess the thinking of the world, speak like the people in the world, and has not renewed in the mind with the Word of God regarding who he is, what he's able to do in Christ, he hasn't learned to yield to the Holy Spirit. The more we renew our mind with the Word of God, the more we will yield to the Holy Spirit. We will grow spiritually. We live in the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus that has set us free from the law of sin and death. We are able to overcome the flesh, because we have the nature of God. What we were not able to do is enabled by the power of the Holy Spirit and the new creation in Christ. Amen? If your word has been destroying your life, relationship, and work, then you need to believe in the redeemed personality. We need to believe that we can be different through the new creation, even when we belong to the category of those who has a sharp tongue or known to hurt people with our words. You might be someone who knows that you are destroying relationship with your words. You are struggling, but I would like to encourage all of us that we can do it. Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You need to begin to speak for what you can do and say things that are different. The Bible says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Therefore, you say what you believe you have been redeemed of. Believe that you are saved, connected to the grapevine of Jesus Christ. Therefore, you and I are able to produce good fruit. Say and act on the truth. Believe that you can do all things, including saying words that edify, comfort, and build up others. Believe that the old person who used to say foolish, harsh, condescending, hurtful words is crucified with Christ, died and buried with Christ. You are a new creation with a redeemed personality. You are able to walk in the newness of life. The fountain that is flowing out of your heart is life-giving, pure, fresh, and refreshing to the hearers. Amen. That's who you are. That's who I am. Verse 45 of the main text says, a good man out of the good treasure of his heart brings forth good. And an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart brings forth evil. For out of the abundance of his mouth speaks. Our word reveals what fills our heart. The fruit is referring to our words, which in turn reveal to us what is filling our hearts. As Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks. It is also has to do with what we think, because as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. We are a product of our thought life that affects our heart. Colossians chapter 4, verse 6 says, let your speech always be with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how you ought to answer each other. Let me give you an example. When a family member has done many things for the family, one of the love languages is doing things for others and affirmation is the other. So instead of saying to the person, I never asked you to do all this, these remarks make the person feel unappreciated and look foolish. You might want to rephrase the way you respond by saying, thank you, my dear. You are such a blessing. We wonder what will be like, what it will be like if it's not for you doing so much for us to support the family. We are truly blessed to have you. Amen. Can you sense the difference between we never asked you to do all this as compared to saying thank you and being appreciative? Let me give you another example of an unappreciative and discontented wife. The husband said, I really dreaded special occasions. My wife always focused on something she was not happy about. It was as if she wanted to sabotage her birthday, Valentine's Day, wedding anniversary, Mother's Day celebration. He said, I organized a big birthday party celebration at the house with catering, flowers, etc., and invited friends and a couple of neighbors that we knew. Her response after the party was, why did you invite that woman to my party? Another year, I could not get the type of birthday cake she wanted. The bakery no longer made them. Why did you get the cake I like? Another time, the gourmet food, foie gras, was left on the kitchen table while I was preparing a romantic setting in the dining room. Why are you letting the food get cold? The list of angry rebuffs went on. The diamonds are too small. The flowers are the wrong color and type. The flowers had too much green in them. Is that it? Is that all I've got? Everyone and everything in the house seems to upset her. I became depressed and withdrew from the relationship, which ended in a divorce. I don't know this couple, but there will be similar cases out there because people are different, but they are predictably different. I will speak generally on cases like this. There are strengths and weaknesses in every personality. The opposite will always attract, but it will get into each other's nerve when they are married because they always feel that they will never measure up to the other person's expectation. It will be even more frustrating if we are trying to change the person and we can't change them. We need to remember that when we marry a person, it will include the emotional baggage in their lives. It works both ways. We should pray for them and believe that the Lord is able to bring about the change. In fact, there's no perfect marriage. There will always be adjustment throughout the whole married life. We will truly need to walk in the Spirit and allow the fruit of the Holy Spirit to flow out of us in order for us to have the patience, kindness, goodness, and self-control to work out the differences. It will always be very helpful if we're able to apply what we have heard through the sermon today. If we apply the above scriptures of let your speech always be with grace, seasoned with salt, then we will have to proactively bridle our tongue and understand each other well. We should extend grace to one another. You will realize that a husband in this example is a very detailed person, while the wife was a very vocal personality. The greatest fear of those who are detailed is criticism. Every comment will be amplified when it is uttered to a perfectionist and a detailed person. We will withdraw something from his emotional reservoir when we give a negative comment. This man's love language is possibly doing something for the other person. Unfortunately, the love language wasn't appreciated, and to make matters worse, there was a withdrawal from his love reservoir when negative and hurtful words were uttered. He will feel that he will never be good enough, nor will he measure up to the standard. In fact, she might not even be able to plan to such detail for a celebration unless the wife is also a very detailed person. It is always easy to criticize. How are we able to change and be appreciative of this person who is detailed and does everything to love his spouse? We need to change the way we speak. We need to speak words that edify, seasoned with salt and grace to the hearer. Words that makes the person feel appreciated and loved. We are to do unto others as we want others to do unto us. The spouse might want to say, "You are such a blessing. What I truly appreciate that you remember every date so well. You remember my birthday. You make time for our anniversary. Look at all the detailed preparation and the beautiful flowers. You are such a darling." We are topping up his love reservoir when we are appreciative and gracious. The wife should be generous and gracious to praise the husband for being so detailed and thoughtful instead of criticizing and being discontented. As for the wife's problem, one of the underlying problems is insecurity, discontentment, and the need to have all the focus on herself. The person who has a vocal personality needs to be the center of the party, the life of a party. The greatest fear of this person is rejection. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth will speak. Honestly, as a believer, it doesn't really matter how big or small the diamond is. It is godliness with contentment is great gain. It is appreciating a husband who has gone through the extensive preparation to celebrate love as husband and wife. If she truly knows the personality of the husband and the fear of criticism and a perfectionist, then she will ensure that he will feel loved and appreciated for the effort that he has put into the celebration. As husband and wife, we will know each other better through the years. Therefore, we should work on the love languages so that we will be able to love each other as we love ourselves rather than devour one another with our words. We are able to build each other up. We belong to the good tree. Amen. Let me give you another example. A conversation between the husband and the wife. It goes like this. "What have you been doing at home all day?" It's a rhetoric question used to suggest that you had all the time at home doing nothing. Why did you do it? Why couldn't you help them? "If I wasn't working, who is going to pay the mortgage or rent?" An excuse for not being a present parent and not setting boundaries at home. For example, checking phone every second or working long hours at the office or at home. Let me remind the husband. 1 Peter 3:7 says, "Husband, likewise, dwell with them with understanding, giving honor to the wife as to the weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers may not be hindered." The remark, What have you been doing at home all day? Doesn't help the homemaker who cares for the children. Basically, this remark is suggesting that the person is useless, incapable, and poor in management. Let us remember that let your speech always be gracious, seasoned with salt, that you may know how to ought to answer each other. There are roles, responsibilities, and expectations in a marriage. In fact, the trailing spouse might be struggling with an identity crisis if he or she has given up her job to be with you in Shanghai. It is a terrible feeling to be unappreciated and spoken to condescendingly. This remark is like knocking the person to the ground who is already tired, helpless, and struggling with different issues, including self-doubt. What she really needs is emotional support besides practical help when he comes home. There are lots of things to be done at home depending on age gap between the children. Not everyone is able to multitask and has different giftings. The husband needs to play the role of the father and the husband besides just having his identity as a corporate man. He is also a child of the living God. And in this case, the husband needs to set aside time to ask what needed to be done and probably coach the child who needs help in schoolwork. He could say, "Dear, I know it's not easy being a homemaker and to look after our children. I cannot imagine doing this on my own. Please let me know how I'm able to contribute to build up this home. I will always make time for you and the family. We are a team and we will make this work together." Can you sense the difference in the speech, in the tone, in applying grace to be seasoned with salt so that the hearer will be edified, encouraged? Because we need to know that there's tremendous power in our words. In conclusion, all of us belong to the good tree because we are a new creation with the nature of God in our hearts. A good tree will have good fruits shown through our conduct and our words. We are made in the image of God. God spoke the entire creation into being. Likewise, our words are filled with power to either edify or tear a person down. We are taught to bridle our tongue in order not to cause any damage to anyone. We should not lash out or say whatever we want without constraint, especially when we are angry. Self-control is one of the 9 fruit of the Holy Spirit. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth will speak. It doesn't help to build relationship when one has a sharp tongue because it pushes away many people once they are hurt by our words. Every one of us need to be slow to speak and quick to listen. We will speak word of edification and affirmation so that it will impart grace to the person. Let us do unto others as we want others to do unto us. Let our speech always be seasoned with salt and with grace. Now, nobody is perfect, including myself. And let us practice speaking graciously to one another because we belong to the good tree. Amen. Let's bow our head and pray. With every head bow and every eyes closed, I'd like to especially pause here for a while. There's someone out there. You are in a very toxic relationship. The Lord knows. And the Lord wants you to be bold, to make certain decisions, to push that pause button, to deal with the situation, to get out of the relationship, to work through a counselor, to bring about restoration. If you are that tormentor, you need help. You need someone to help you to break out of the vicious cycle. You know that you are not doing well. You know that you are doing evil things in this relationship. God loves you unconditionally and He cares for you. God wants to bless your relationship. There can be a turnaround in this relationship. You can be blessed in this relationship rather than allow the toxicity to continue to develop in the relationship and tear each other apart by actions and words. Cry out to God. Seek help. Seek professional help. Father, I'd like to pray for this couple or couples. I pray that, Father, they will have the boldness to deal with the toxic relationship, and that, Father, you restore to them a blessed relationship in Christ, O God. And right now, if you're listening to this sermon, you're not a Christian, you have never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, but you'd like to receive Him today because it will make a world of a difference in your life, not just for now, but for eternity, I'd like you to say this prayer with me. Say, Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for sending Jesus to die for me on the cross. Forgive me of my sin, for I'm a sinner. Come into my heart today. Be my Lord and be my Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have said that prayer, I'd really like to hear from you. Write to me. My email address is written at the bottom of this page. We'd like to follow up with you to send you some materials. Right now, I'd like to pray for the church. Father, I give you praise and thanks that your word has gone forth. It shall not return void before you. It shall accomplish all that your purpose for it to do. We give you praise and thanks that we are a good tree because we are connected to the grapevine of Jesus Christ. That as we abide in Him and His word abide in us, we will bear much fruit. And Father, you want us to be blessed holistically, spiritually, emotionally, physically. And I pray that, Father, even as we choose to yield to the Holy Spirit, to breathe our tongue and allow our words to be seasoned with salt and to extend grace to one another, Father, I want to believe that every one of us, every family, every individual who is listening to this message will have a turnaround in their marriage relationship, in their individual life, in their family life, Father God. And through this, they will experience love, joy, peace, and warmth in their home. Now may the love of the Father, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore. Amen.
Hi Church, I'm Kathleen, and I love to thank all of you for your continuous support for ICS and connecting with us through our online services during this period. We hope you've enjoyed and were greatly blessed by our weekly messages. And if you do show us some love and support by clicking the like button, subscribe to our YouTube channel by hitting the subscribe button below, and be part of this family. Also, you may hit the notification bell to receive a weekly notification so you won't miss out on our brand new video, which we post every Sunday. If you are new to SAS and haven't already, please don't forget to check us out on our website, Facebook, and Instagram as we post new updates every week. God bless you.